Welcome to Exhibitor Lounge, sponsored by ExhibitEdge.com. Now, I'm your host and your trade show mixologist, Michael Gray. Here each week you receive simple, practical, and proven tips to improve your trade show marketing strategy and get better results while maximizing your budget. Hey, a big side note, if you are just reading the video text in the Exhibitor Lounge newsletter, I highly recommend that you open the video as there are a lot of illustrations to assist you in understanding this information. Okay, the VGA to HDMI connection is the most common cross-port connection I see right now on the show floor. Now, many older or company-issued laptops still use a VGA 15-pin or D-sub connection, which it is sometimes called, as the housing is shaped like the capital letter D. Now, many people also call it a 14-pin VGA, as one pin is missing even though there are 15-pin locations on the plugins. Now, this is very normal and does not mean that the cable is bad. When clients buy a new monitor or rent a consumer-grade monitor, they soon realize that the newer monitor does not have a VGA input port. And newer monitors are eliminating this port as the technology progresses to all digital equipment. Monitors are cheaper and lighter, and this means that something's gotta go, so no VGA. Now, a VGA output on your computer to an HDMI input connection on a monitor will require an active adapter or converter to convert the signal from analog to digital. A passive adapter that just changes the plug-in will never work. Now, it's extremely important to know that this conversion process starts as analog and finishes as digital. So when you are buying an active adapter or converter, make sure it says VGA to HDMI and not the other way around. Now, here are some common things to look for. Number one, the price. VGA to HDMI converters are usually more expensive than HDMI to VGA. Now, you would pay 2 to 3 times more for a VGA to HDMI converter. I mean, expect to pay $70 to $100 for a good VGA to HDMI converter with sound. All right, number two, don't expect to walk into your neighborhood electronics store and pick one up. Now, these converters are not in high demand, as they're more for temporary crossover connections. Now, these temporary needs are more prevalent at trade shows, since that's where you see more borrowed or rented equipment. All right, number three, most VGA to HDMI active adapters or converters are very short. So you will need to have a cable to plug into one end to span the distance between the computer and the monitor. Number four, if the product says VGA female to HDMI male, don't assume it converts the signal the way you want it to. Verify the direction and make sure that it's VGA out to HDMI in. As always, please respond with your questions or comments and let others know about ExhibitorLounge.com. Hey, we'll see you next week. Until then, I'm your host, Michael Gray, telling you to relax in the Exhibitor Lounge.